Welcome to the spoken tutorial on static methods. In this tutorial, we will learn what are static methods, defining static methods, difference between instance methods and static methods, and how to use static methods. Here we are using Ubuntu 14.04, JDK 1.7, and Eclipse 4.3.1. To follow this tutorial, you must have knowledge of basics of Java and Eclipse IDE. You should also have the knowledge of instance variables, methods, and static variables in Java. If not, for relevant Java tutorials, please visit the link shown. A static method is a method which is associated with the entire class. It is also called a class method and is declared using the static keyword. Static methods are usually used to handle static variables. Now we will switch to Eclipse and create a new project called Static Method Demo. Inside this project, we will create the necessary classes to demonstrate the usage of static methods. We will create a new class StudentEnroll. Let us see how to use static methods with an example. The example is very similar to the one which is used in the static variable tutorial. Here again, we are representing the StudentEnroll class. Recall that the variables name and ID are handled as instance variables. Here the variables organization and total count are common to the entire class. So, they can be treated as static variables. Now, type the following code to represent the StudentEnroll class. Note that there are two static variables, count and org name. Also note that org name is not a static constant, rather it is normal static variable. The static variable org name is initialized as IIT Bombay. Now, click on Source and select Generate constructor using fields. Delete the super keyword from the generated code. Inside the constructor, type count plus plus semicolon. So, the count value is incremented every time an object is created. Now, we will add a method showData to this class to print the values of the variables. So, type public void showData. Within brackets, type the following code to print the values of ID, name and organization name. Now, we will add the static method setOrgName. Type the following code. The setOrgName method represented here is a static method which can modify the value of OrgName. Any method which is used to handle static variables can be defined as a static method. Now, let us explore the differences between instance method and static method. Instance methods can access static variables, whereas a static method can directly access and modify only static variables. Instance methods are invoked only by an object, whereas a static method can be invoked directly without creating an object. We cannot use this and super keyword inside a static method. This is because these keywords refer to the instance of a particular class. In a static context, we can't refer to instances of a class. Let us see what happens if we try to access an instance variable directly inside this static method. Type id equals new id semicolon. Now, an error comes up in Eclipse. It indicates that an instance variable cannot be accessed directly inside a static method. So, let us comment this line and proceed. Now, we will add one more static method, showOrgData. These statements print the values of OrgName and count. Now, right-click on the default package, click New, Class, and then type the name as Demo. Inside this class, we will have the main method. So type main and then press Ctrl space to generate the main method. We will create a few objects of StudentEnroll class to represent student enrollments. So type the following code to create three objects S1, S2 and S3. Now let us invoke the showData method to print the enrollment details. Type the following code to invoke showData method on S1, S2 and S3. Let us also invoke the method showOrgData to print the values of ORG name and count. Since it is a static method, we can invoke it directly using its class name. To do so, type this code. Now let us run the demo program. We can see that the values of the variables corresponding to S1, that is IT101, Adil and IIT Bombay gets printed. Similarly, the values corresponding to S2 and S3 are also printed. Note that the value of ORG name, that is IIT Bombay, is common for S1, S2 and S3. ORG name and count are printed separately by the static method showOrgData. Note that the organization name is printed as IIT Bombay. The value of the number of student enrollments is printed as 3, as we have already created 3 objects. A static method can be invoked directly by the class name itself. Now let us invoke the static method setOrgName. We will change the organization name from IIT Bombay to IIT Mumbai. So type the following code. Now let us once again invoke the showData method on S1, S2 and S3 to print the enrollment details. For that, type the following code again. Once again, let us invoke the method showOrgData to print the values of ORG name and count. To do so, type this code. Now run the demo program again. We can see that the organization name is changed to IIT Mumbai. Let us come back to slides. Object references can be passed to a static method. This way, a static method can access the instance variables of that particular object. Let us try it in our code. Switch to Eclipse and go to the Student Enroll class. Now, in the setOrgName method, pass another argument as an object of Student Enroll class. So after string org type comma student enroll yes. Now inside this method uncomment id equals new id and instead of id type s.id. Now go to the demo class. Let us modify the function call to set org name method by passing the student enroll object s1. So here after IIT Mumbai type S1. Now run the demo program again. We can see that the value of ID for S1 has changed to new ID. Let us summarize. In this tutorial, we have learnt about what is a static method and when it is used, how to differentiate static methods and instance methods, and how to create and invoke static methods. This assignment is a continuation of the static variable assignment. Make sure that you have completed the static variable assignment. We will highlight only the modifications here. Here we have a variable to represent status. It is used to indicate whether the car is in for service or out after service. We will also have another variable to represent number of cars out after service. Define a method serviceCarC which updates the status to out. Accordingly, it modifies the values for number of cars in for service, number of cars out after service. Also define a method show to print all the car details. As before, we need to perform the following as listed. Note that we have to identify and define the static method as required. Also create a demo class. Inside the main method, create a few objects of car service. Invoke the service method on some of them. Invoke the show method using all the objects and verify the results. The video at the following link summarizes the spoken tutorial project. Please download and watch it. The Spoken Tutorial Project team conducts workshops using Spoken Tutorials and gives certificates on passing the online test. For more details, please write to us. Spoken Tutorial Project is funded by the NMEICT, MHRD, Government of India. More information on this mission is available at the link shown. This script has been contributed by Department of Information Technology, Amal Jyoti College of Engineering. This is Priya from IIT Bombay. Thanks for joining.